अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह रब्बिल आलमीन अस्सलातु वस्सलामु अला सिद्दीकिल अमीन रसूलिल करीम अम्मा बाद अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। आई एम मोहम्मद ज़ैनुद्दीन।
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह लज़ी बिइज़्ज़तिही जलालिही ततिम्मस सालिहात। अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। आई एम अम्मा मोहम्मद सानूर।
We, the host of this session, stand before you to present a scenario of children of our age around this huge world.
Everything in this universe, every creature and the things it does, is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Every child has a right to live. They should be born healthy, grow up healthy and safe. They should have healthy food to eat, clean water to drink, a safe place to live and basic education. Are you not amazed to know how lucky your children are?
Do not forget, we are here to discuss the children of our age around this world.
The fortune of children of my age around this world in present day situation is variable and depends on numerous factors such as their geographical location, access to resources, socio-economic conditions and many more.
The thing which makes the difference is whether they are evolving or stagnating. Isn't that a thing to wonder? We hereby present to you the verses of Allah from Surah Zumar. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Can those of knowledge and those who do not know be deemed equal? Absolutely not. Most of the children of my age live in poverty, lacking access to basic necessities such as healthcare, education, clean water and good food.
As we converse about education, it seems to be a quite necessary factor. The confidence I have of studying here is because of education, and thereby many more factors arise as we talk about it.
Of course, Amar, education breeds confidence, confidence breeds hope, and hope breeds peace.
Due to financial conditions, parents or the guardians of the children are unable to send them to school or college in which the children lack education.
Not always financial conditions. How about children living in war-borne countries or those with feeble economies? Can't we see street vendors, hawkers and laborers of our age? What if they were educated?
The persecuting factor arises here is how we abide and haunt.
Could you please elaborate that sentence?
Of course, Zainadi. Digitalization, use of smart devices, fascinating gadgets have also been playing a crucial role in molding one's life.
Why always technology? Several spend quality time with family and friends, whereas not many of us are busy in making a better tomorrow. Do you give time to yourself too? Do you think of others too who are not in a better condition than you? Then will you not reason? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, look at those who are beneath you and do not look at those who are above you. For it is more suitable that you should not consider as less the blessing of Allah.
Can children of my age be so mature enough to think of others too?
Do you know what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? He said, whoever looks upon an orphan and supports him will be as close to me as an index finger is to a middle finger in paradise. Have you not thought of morality? Haven't you observed of the Muslim countries? MashaAllah, how strong their iman is. And we run away when it comes to our lives.
Astaghfirullah, may Allah forgive such people. Do you know, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, one who endures with fortitude and forgives achieves a matter of high resolve.
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, education is the backbone of a nation. To seek knowledge is a sacred duty. To teach it is a noble mission. Cleanliness is half of it, and knowledge is the other half. The best of you are those who learn and teach. Also, he said that whoever takes a path upon which to obtain knowledge, Allah makes the path to paradise easy on him.
Not all can become educated or knowledgeable. Do you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he gives wisdom unto whom he wills, and he unto whom wisdom is given has surely received abundant good, but none remember except men of understanding. Also, it is compulsory the acquisition of knowledge on every male and female who believes.
Now let us look at the other face of the coin. Children of my age around the world are changing the world by voicing out their problems and finding solutions to it.
There is mounting scientific evidence that young children are involved in finding a solution. There is mounting scientific evidence that young children have natural inclination to be kind and helpful. And of course, it is the duty of a teenager like me to behave with dignity, tranquility and reverence. Such an example is Greta Thunberg. a girl who showed her concern towards the growing threat of climate change at the age of 15, and Ara Hawk, who is raising money for young cancer patients. Isn't it impressive? Isn't it impressive that young children like me are involved in finding a solution for climate change and also helping those with cancer? MashaAllah.
They are never behind in technology too. Have you not heard of Bilal from Morocco, who's been building robots since he was 4 and is now a self-taught engineer at the age of 14? And of Gitanjali Rao, who was awarded $25,000 at the age of 11 for inventing a device that can detect lead in water?
Bringing change takes time, but some children prove that it's never too early, not too late, to try and save this world. While most engage in play, these children are tackling world issues. Remarkable indeed. Every child is special, important, and deserves to have the rights and respect.
Train yourself tomorrow. Well in manners,
well in hard work,
and well in soulness.
Train yourself for a better tomorrow.
This may seem dry as dust to you, but it is the bitter taste of truth. Work, but for a last pleasure, and see how the reward emerges.
Indeed, your reward awaits.
And finally, I need you all to think about it. You find many such children of this age or our age around you or around this world. Do you have any better plans for such children to be better human beings in future?
Jazakallah.